Fine. So today we are going to do problem practice on this chapter, electromagnetic induction. Short form of that is EMI. And you might have seen how this chapter is. The theory for this chapter is very less. But when you look at the numericals, the varieties are many. The reason why such a small chapter has so many numericals, because this chapter assumes that you have all the knowledge of magnetism, you have all the knowledge of electrostatics, and on top of it, something related to how the EMF is induced. And then you have these mechanics topics are also mixed with the concept of electromagnetism. That creates a good mix of many concepts together. Because of that, multiple numericals are getting generated. All right, so we'll quickly brush up the topics related to only this chapter. Of course, there are few things that it takes from the previous chapters. For example, you should know what is a magnetic field due to the various shapes and structures. So that is from moving charges and magnetism chapter. Anyways, so this chapter is about EM induction. Okay, as in how you can induce magnetic field from electric field and vice versa. Okay, so basically, if I can write, it's about how you induce E and B from each other. Okay. Now you have a relation for the magnetic flux. Okay. Magnetic flux can be written as integral of B dot dA. Okay, now when I'm finding the flux, do I need loop or some area? My question is, can I find out flux through this structure, which is curved structure from A and B? Will it have any flux?
So it needs to be closed.
Needs to be closed. It needs to be in a loop. Okay, so when it comes to circuits, flux you can find only when there is a loop. Okay, so that is the basic need of this. Once you find the flux, which is equal to, let's say area vector is, let's say area vector is a constant and B vector is also direction of that is constant. So you can, let's say B and A, let's say you're talking about a very small area, you can write down flux as B into A into cos of theta. Okay, here I'm assuming angle is constant, area is constant, and B is also constant. Otherwise, you have to integrate this whole thing to get flux. So this is the magnetic flux. Okay, now this is I'm saying B, A, and theta are constant in space. Okay, at a particular time, everything is constant, but things can change with time. Okay, so when you differentiate it, there can be change in that with time. With space, it is not changing, but with time, it can change. And with time, if it changes, it creates an EMF, which is equal to minus of N times d phi b by dt. Okay, so n is number of turns and this is rate of change of flux. All right, and once you get EMF, this EMF is induced in a loop, and if loop resistance is R, current will be equal to this EMF divided by R. Okay, now the current in the loop will be generated. How will you find out the direction of current?
So by using Lenz's law.
Correct. So direction of current is such that it opposes what?
The cause.
The thing which created it.
What creates it?
The change in flux.
Correct. It opposes change in flux. Change in flux. Remember that. Okay. And Lenz's law goes beyond just talking about the flux. Lenz's law can be applied directly. I'll tell you when I'll go there in that concept. So yeah, so what I was saying was, when I was changing flux with respect to time, I can have magnetic field changing with time, and dB by dt into A into cos theta plus NB dA by dt into cos theta minus of NBA sine theta d theta by dt. Okay. Of course, there is a minus sign, but that minus sign is having just physical significance. It doesn't create any, mathematical significance, because it's just an indicative of the Lenz's law fact that it will oppose. So that's why just a minus sign will put it over there. So this is the EMF. Remember that any three things can change: magnetic field, area, and theta. All three can change. Some may contest that even number of turns can change with time. That why can't that create the EMF? But the formula for EMF is what? Minus of number of turns into rate of change of the flux in one of the turns. Okay, so the derivative is not for number of turns. Then we have the current, which is dq by dt, to be equal to EMF, which is d phi by dt divided by the resistance. Okay, so from here you can see that dt dt you can cancel out, and you can get dq is equal to d phi by r. All right, so if you integrate it over a period of time, this integral is anyway independent of the time. So doesn't matter whatever time frame you take, the amount of charge that has flown through the loop, which has undergone a change of flux of delta phi, you can relate them like this. Okay. These are few things which sometimes get asked, so you should be clear. So this is about the flux, rate of change of flux, and yeah, small equation on the amount of charge that has flown for a given change in the flux. Now, to induce the EMF, you don't need a loop. Okay, there can be a situation of motional EMF, but the formula you have is valid only for the loop. This formula, E is equal to minus of N d phi by dt, is valid for the loop. But it is very much possible that if a rod of length L moves with velocity V in a magnetic field B, it will create an EMF of BLV. Okay, length is L. But all three should be perpendicular. B should be perpendicular to the length, should be perpendicular to the velocity. The length, velocity, and B should be perpendicular. If they are not perpendicular, take the perpendicular components. Okay. Over here, can you tell me which one is at a higher potential? Point number one or point number two?
Two,
right? You can use right hand curl rule and look at the direction in which the positive charge will feel the force. So electron will feel the force in opposite direction. So electron will tend to accumulate there, and the positive charges will tend to accumulate there. So they will keep on accumulating till the electric field that is developed inside the rod balances the attraction between them. Okay. So you can see over here, the electric field is getting induced inside the rod, which creates an EMF of this much. So this is one of the situations in which charge is static, but then also there is an electric field. So yeah, this is the EMF, motional EMF. Sometimes you have a situation in which you have like a wire like that moving with velocity V in a magnetic field B. In that scenario, you have to take, you know, there is a derivation to it. I think we have done it, but not required right now. So you can take a projection in the direction perpendicular to the velocity, take the furthest point from here, furthest point there. This length is, let's say, L. The EMF will be equal to BLV. You don't need to worry about the twists and turns in the wire. Just take the projected length, which is perpendicular to the velocity. Like this, you can get the motional EMF. Okay. Now, once you know about the motional EMF, this sort of thing which I'm drawing right now is very popular, and I'm sure you have seen it already. So this kind of structure in which there are two rails. Okay, here they can connect resistance, inductor, whatnot. They can connect anything. And you have a rod like this. This rod is sliding with velocity V, okay, in a magnetic field B, which is into. This kind of thing is very popular in problem solving. So here you can find out the EMF between point 1 and point 2 by using motional EMF, and you can also find out EMF, same EMF you'll get by considering the flux inside this loop. You can get the EMF. Okay, so using both the scenarios, you'll get BLV only as EMF. BLV you'll get as EMF, and because of that you'll get current, which is BLV by R. Now, because there is a current in the loop and there's a rod, okay? So this rod, because of this external magnetic field B, will experience a force. Which direction that force will be?
Backward.
Why?
It opposes.
Opposes.
Why? Why? Say it again.
So because of Lenz's law.
Because of Lenz's law. So you can apply Lenz's law directly. You don't need to find out the direction of current, then from direction of current, use right-hand thumb rule to get the direction of force. No. The basic cause of the EMF induction is movement of the rod. Movement of rod should be opposed. How it is getting opposed? By doing anything. And one of the thing is force. So force should oppose the velocity. So that's the reason why the force is in this direction. Okay, this is the magnetic force, and according to that, the direction of current will be, you can find out that. So this is the current, the magnitude of force is IL cross B. Okay, and you can see that current, length and magnetic field, they are perpendicular to each other. So the force will be B square L square V by R, IL cross B. Now, sometimes you need to be paying a little bit more attention towards direction of force. The direction of force should be perpendicular to both. You should remember that magnetic field and length of the rod both. Okay. I have seen some cases it becomes a little tricky. So this is the force. Using this force, you can also get the power that is developed to power that is delivered to the rod. Power that is delivered to the rod is force into velocity, which is also equal to I square R. So whatever power you deliver, whatever work you do here, it is getting lost as heat from the resistance, because there is no energy storage device in this circuit. So entire work, whatever you do, instantly gets converted into heat and it gets released. So this is the motional EMF. Then whatever we have revised till now regarding EMF and the rod and everything, many students, more than 70 to 80% students think that chapter is only about this. Okay. But the reality is there is at least, 30% more chapter is remaining, which talks about inductor. Okay, so inductor is a big chunk of the chapter which is ignored, and it is known to everyone. Okay, it's an open secret. So if I have to give you a question on this chapter, I will create some inductive circuit and ask you to analyze that. Fine. And yes, lately many questions are getting asked from this topic, so do not ignore it. So inductance, you know, is a concept. Just like you can say Q is equal to some constant times V, this constant is called capacitance. Similarly, flux can be written proportional to the current, and the proportionality constant is the inductance. Okay, and as the definition of induction suggests, the geometrical features, just like geometrical feature of capacitor is what? Two conductors separated by insulator. Similarly, it requires a flux. So inductance is only possible for loops. A loop is required. Okay, otherwise you can't define flux. Okay, and EMF is d phi by dt. Okay, so this is equal to L di by dt. And according to Lenz's law, minus sign will come. Now, minus sign means that whatever EMF induced will oppose the cause. What is the cause of EMF induced in the inductor? Everyone?
Changing current.
Change in the current. So, inductor does not, inductor doesn't like current to change. Okay. If current is decreasing, let's say you have an inductor like this, like that. If current is going like this and it is decreasing, it will try to increase the current. Now, if it tries to increase the current, which one is at a higher potential? Point number A or point number B?
Point A.
No.
B.
It is B. So this is minus, this is plus. So this will push the current this way. Okay, it becomes like a battery. If current is increasing, then it will be reverse. All right. In both the cases, you can blindly write down that the change in the, sorry, the potential drop is minus L di by dt. The signs will automatically take care. If current is decreasing, di by dt will be a negative quantity. So when you multiply by minus one, it becomes positive, minus to plus. Okay. So do not think too much on it. Whenever you have inductor, you'll applying Kirchhoff loop rule. Just write down minus L di by dt whenever you're crossing along the direction of the current. Don't need to worry much. And this inductance is such that sometimes the flux is because of its own current. Then this constant proportionality is called the self-inductance. And sometimes the flux is because of the current on the other other thing can be loop or can be wire or anything. So when that happens, the constant proportionality is called mutual inductance. All right. And you might have seen that inductor when it is connected across a resistance like this. When I close the switch, immediately after closing the switch, what is the current, everyone?
Zero.
Zero. It doesn't like the current to suddenly increase. It will slowly increase. So when it is switched off like this, then you can apply Kirchhoff loop rule. E minus L di by dt minus IR is equal to zero. We have solved this differential equation and we have got the expression for the current also, which is E by R 1 minus e to the power minus RT by L. This is what you get. And L by R is a time constant for inductive circuit. These are just some basic things. So these kind of questions are becoming more popular, in which you have a loop, in which resistance and inductors are there and the DC source is there. Okay, I'm not talking about the alternating current. So these kind of questions are getting popular. I mean, every year I see more and more questions. Okay, now for solenoid, in our syllabus, we have derived the expression for the self-inductance and mutual inductance. The self-inductance is mu naught, mu r, n square, area of cross-section into L. Okay, and mutual inductance between the two coils, between the two solenoid, mu naught, mu r, n1, n2, pi, radius of the smaller square into L. Okay, so I don't know, maybe this may be helpful, but usually direct formulas are not helpful in the JE exams. And in NEET, sometimes it is useful. NEET is slightly more theoretical. Anyways, so the energy stored in the solenoid, sorry, not solenoid, inductor, you might be knowing it is half Li square, right? And because of that, you can derive the expression for the density of the energy in a magnetic field B, B square by 2 mu naught. Okay, density of the energy in the electric field E is half epsilon naught E square. So wherever the magnetic field is B, B square by 2 mu naught is joule per meter cube energy stored in that zone. Okay, so after this, there is a small topic of AC generator, which is nothing but it's an application of Lenz's law. So nothing special about it, just that it is an instrument. So flux, there is a coil that rotates between the magnetic field. So flux is BA cos of omega t, right? So EMF will be equal to minus of d phi by dt. So this will be equal to BA omega sine of omega t. And from here you can get the current also. The amplitude of EMF is BA into omega. Okay, in fact, there is number of turns also, N also we should write. In DC generator and DC AC motor, there is a portion. Yes, KTG, everything is there. Okay, as long as, you know, it is an application of the Lenz's law. In fact, they don't need to tell you theory for the AC generator. Because what is it? Rate of change of flux only? Lenz's law is there in our curriculum. So indirectly AC generator, they can ask questions. But they can't ask you like in DC generator, what is the function of the split rings and brush and all that. So they can't ask you in detail. If there are both L and M, potential drop is Lm and yes. The total flux is equal to Li plus M12I, this is Li1I2 plus M13I3. You can keep on writing the flux like this. Flux because of its own current, flux because of the adjacent current I2, flux because of adjacent current I3. So total EMF will be derivative of this. So yes, theoretically that is the case, but then when it comes to numericals, mutual inductance are ignored actually. So only self-inductance are there, unless it is specified exclusively.
So, So when doing solenoid, we were treating like length is much greater than radius, but in module, there was some case where it's not greater and they took like two angles, cos theta one and cos theta two. Could you explain that?
What are you talking about? Self-inductance?
No, sir, like solenoid only. We took L is greater than R, right? Much greater.
While deriving what?
Sir, magnetic field.
Magnetic field?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that is, that we will do. In fact, after the class, I'll send you that. It is not part of EMI. Okay.
Okay, sir.
In fact, when they mention solenoid, you take it as an ideal one only. In fact, you're asking to solve a numerical, all right? It is a part of a numerical. Don't treat it like a derivation. Can a rod have EMF if magnetic field is varying. If a magnetic field is varying, can a rod, no, rod won't have an EMF. If magnetic field is varying, it requires movement of the rod systematic. There should be a systematic movement of the free electrons inside the rod. You, what happens is that electrons are moving randomly. Okay. So because of the magnetic field, they will experience force in random direction. So net net, the force get cancelled out and nowhere accumulation happens. But when rod is moving systematically in one direction, then you can have velocity of electron as random velocity plus systematic velocity. So force due to random velocity is ignored, only systematic velocity force is there, and because of that electrons get accumulated over there and there is an EMF that gets generated. So systematic movement of rod is required. Understood, Ruchir?
Yes, sir.
But then yes, time varying magnetic field do generate electric field. For that you don't need a rod, it can generate in open space. So we have learned that in EM wave also, right? An EM wave will get generated. So let me quickly tell you that the induced electric field, induced electric field EMF is equal to integral of E dot dl. This is equal to rate of change of magnetic flux. Okay, there is a minus sign both sides, so it will get cancelled away. And if circular symmetry is there, circular symmetry is present, then integral E dot dl can be written as E into 2 pi r. This is equal to rate of change of magnetic flux. So electric field can be written as this, 1 by 2 pi r d phi b by dt. And the induced electric field will create a closed loop. If there is a circular symmetry, the electric field will be circular like this, which is never the case when electric field is created by the static charges. So only induced electric field create the closed loop, and they are non-conservative in nature. Non-conservative. So if you move a charge from here and come back to there, total work done is not zero. So you can't have potential energy of induced electric field. So okay, so this is the summary.
Kirchhoff's
of
rule not work there.
What?
Then will Kirchhoff's loop rule not work in this kind of system?
No, it is about conservation. It is only true for the conservative forces. In fact, I thought you should be wondering the case when we talk about a loop like this in a magnetic field get shrunk and it's area is reduced, EMF is generated and current is there. So EMF between which two points? Have you ever wondered between which two points EMF, or between which two points potential difference? No, right? Here also the electric field that get generated, it is having this nature. Okay, but then you can ignore that nature. Because this is analogous to having a battery over there. But in this case, if you go around in this loop, I mean, there is no physical loop as such. There is no current as such. So you can't ignore the non-conservative nature here itself. So more you go in depth, I mean, more there are things to explore. So it is this topic, induced electric field, is something which is not touched in your NCERT textbook. They have ignored it. All right, so let us start solving numericals. I have around 60 to 70 numericals. Let us see how many we can solve. Okay, we'll take from simpler ones to the difficult ones. You are looking from the side of the magnet. You're standing on the magnet. This is you. Anticlockwise, current will flow like this.
Yes.
Okay. Over here, current will flow in opposite direction.
Yes.
Okay. Because the induced current is not opposing the magnetic field. Induced current is opposing the change in flux. Okay. So wherever the flux is increasing, it will try to reduce that. Wherever it is decreasing, it will try to increase it. Is it also simple only? The current in loop A decreases with time. So this flux, is decreasing. It will try to increase it by having a current like this. Okay, will it attract or repel?
It'll attract, sir.
It'll attract because of Faraday's law. Okay. It'll try to bring this closer so that it can increase the flux. Okay, so directly you can apply the Lenz's law, and B is exact opposite of the A. Okay, B is a ripple. Part A, first answer.
So in part A, it's like two parts, right?
Part A, there are three wires connected like this.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Part A, what is the answer? How much current, I mean, which direction the current will be? This way or this way on this connector?
Both. So it'll add up to zero.
It'll add up.
There won't be current.
There won't be any current over there. Okay. So if you consider it as if it's part of this thing, one here, one there, like that, if you consider. So current is diminishing, which is directed away. So going in, diminishing, it will try to increase it. So one current will be like this, other current will be like that. So when you add it up, this will become zero. So that is how the current will be like this. Over here.
So, for that question, can you say that since the field is along the circle, if I take that path, then the potential difference is zero across those two points.
Between A and B.
Yes, sir.
It has to be actually, see the resistance of this wire is also zero, right?
So even if it wasn't, can't you say that the potential is...
Potential is zero, correct. Potential is zero. This one? No current. Here you're telling no current. Why?
But the loop is not complete, right?
Loop is complete, boss. It is like
clockwise.
I have like this, a rectangle which is twisted to make a donut kind of thing.
So, but the thing is not touching this.
But it's still a closed loop, right?
Close, and I kya hai? This is closed.
Okay.
So magnetic field inside this zone is diminishing. It'll try to increase it. So it'll go like this and come out like that. Getting it?
Yes.
It'll go like this, come out like that. Okay. Correct. This one?
No current, sir.
No current. Anywhere. No current on this. No current on this. Okay. But what about current on these two?
So they both go.
Will be
both clockwise.
Both like this.
Yes.
Both opposite. Here. They don't have option. Here they have option. So both will be clockwise like that. Okay. Over there.
So it'll be like clockwise in the bigger circle.
Clockwise bigger?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Because bigger can have larger flux. So that's the reason why it can oppose more. Net-net, it should oppose. The smaller one will compromise. Smaller one will be like supporting it. But this bigger one is opposing. So net-net opposition is there. There is no option because of the twisted this thing. Mathematically, what you can see is that if entire this thing is there, you have twisted it so that... I mean, this area has been rotated by 180 degrees. So its area vector is downwards. Its area vector is upwards. They are making 180 degree with each other. So like that, you can imagine mathematically. Physically, if you analyze, it will be easier.
So there will also be a force on the smaller one trying to flip it, right?
There will be, see, this is a uniform magnetic field. So... the force will not be there. Okay. It's a loop.
Yes, so that's why, like, it's a dipole. So if you rotate it a little bit, then it'll try to go to stable equilibrium.
This is a situation in which right now this, you can consider as if two dipoles are there. This one and this one, two dipoles are there. This one is in stable equilibrium, is it? This is down direction, magnetic dipole moment, and magnetic field is also down. Yeah, this is stable, this is unstable. So this will, there will be a torque which will try to flip it over, okay? Magnetic torque. All right. So I think it should be simple. Figure, conducting loop, straight wire, straight spelling, current shown. If current is increasing continuously, because of this current, the magnetic field is into the plane like this. It increases. So it will try to decrease it by generating current like this, isn't it? So this is the answer, and it will try to, it will get rippled or attracted net.
Rippled. So ripple.
Ripple, right? Rippled. I hope you guys are not getting bored because of simple questions. Soon I will turn the table. I have to take all levels of question, including your CET level to advanced level. You can't make mistake in these questions. Okay. All of you should get it right. Done, all of you?
Wait, sir, just 1 minute.
1 minute, giving you 20 seconds. Okay, the answer is 1, actually -1. Those who have not got the wrong answer, you know, it's a serious thing. All right, so EMF is minus of n d phi by dt 3t square minus 2 into 10 raised to power minus 3. Then put t equal to 2 over here, you get EMF is equal to minus 1. Okay. In fact, minus has just symbolic meaning over there. Even 1 is the correct answer. If you say 1, that is also correct. Minus will just tell the direction. Nobody knows what is plus direction, so how can you say minus? This one. So you have another opportunity to check whether you can trust yourself with calculations. Do the correct calculation, get the correct answer, and be proud of yourself. Okay, Ruchir Singh has answered something which is not correct. Rajdeep has answered, which is again not correct. Any other answer? Have Param calculate.
Okay, sir.
Chaitanya got it correct. Ruchir Singh finally got it. Hia got it. Only these guys have got till now. See, I'm not testing whether you know the concept here. I'm testing your calculations. Okay, I can see more than 70% of you did not get the correct answer. What does it say? The correct answer is EMF equal to 6.75 volts. Okay, so how to do such calculations? First of all, do not put the values in BTL. Okay. At the end, you put the values. Phi 1 is what? Pi into R square into B. Second time, the flux is A square into B. A is a side length of the square. So we are talking about average EMF. So Phi 1 minus Phi 2 or Phi 2 minus Phi 1. Forget about the signs, okay? Sign doesn't matter. Phi 2 minus Phi 1 divided by delta T. So this is equal to Pi R square minus A square into B divided by 0.1 is the time. Okay, in fact 0.1 also you can put it at the end, but it's okay. Now the circle is becoming square, right? So the perimeter should match. 2 pi r should be equal to 4a. So A is equal to pi r by 2. Now you put the values, you will get pi r square minus pi square R square by 4 divided by 0.1 times B. Okay. So simplifying that further, you can take R square common, pi R square, in fact, 1 minus pi by 4 into 10. Now you put the value of R. Do not unnecessarily find out. Nobody is asking you to find out what is A. Okay. So now you put the value of A, your calculation will be at least 2 times simpler than if you would have substituted in the middle. Anyways, the answer is 6.75. We'll move ahead. EMF induced straightforward BLV, the current BLV by R, external force required for constant speed. If it is a constant speed, net force should be zero. Magnetic force is this direction, so your force should be in opposite direction. IL into B, B square L square V by R. Power is force into velocity. B square L square V square by R, and power dissipated is same as power delivered, right? You can see I square R, this is I square R also, if you do, you get the same thing as power. That is in line with the conservation of energy, because energy can't be stored anywhere, so it has to get released. Get the answer in terms of A and B. Don't put the values. Get it in terms of variables. All of you tried. Okay. You have to subtract these two fluxes or not?
Yes.
Their orientations are different, 180 degrees. So the flux will be subtracted. The flux is A square minus B square, total area into B naught sine of omega t, right? So from here, you'll get d phi by dt. A square minus B square into B naught omega cos omega t. Okay, this is the EMF. Current is EMF divided by the resistance. Direct question, this is formula substitution. That divided by rho times 4A plus 4B into cos of omega t. So if you like more crisp answer, A square minus B square divided by A plus B is A minus B. So A minus B, B naught omega divided by 4 times rho into cos of omega t. So this is the current. Okay. Amplitude they asked, right? Find the amplitude of the current. Amplitude is this. This is the amplitude, the bracket term. All right, okay. You don't need to type in the answer. Once you're done, message that you're done. No picture on the WhatsApp. It's okay. All of you do this. Message once you're done. Okay, everyone attempted? All right, Karthik, is it done? Okay, so all of you agree that there will be a magnetic force which will be IL into B. Current is BLV by R, so it will be B square L square V by R. Now this is the formula for the instantaneous force. Okay, it means that at whatever time, whatever is the velocity, magnetic force will be this much. So even the Newton's second law is also the formula for the instantaneous values. Net force is equal to mass time acceleration. So F minus magnetic force is backwards, right? It'll try to oppose it. So F minus B square L square V by R. This is the applied force minus the magnetic force. This is equal to mass times acceleration, which is equal to M dV by dt. All of you understood till here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So M, now you have to, I mean, now this is mathematics actually. This is not physics from here. F minus B square L square by R into V, this is equal to dt. Integrate this. From 0 to t, velocity goes from 0 to v. So now minus of mr by b square l square log of f minus b square l square by r times v divided by f. This is equal to t. So from here, you just simplify the expression. You will get velocity to be equal to fr by b square l square 1 minus e to the power this. Okay. This is how you solve this question. We'll proceed further. In case you have any doubts, you can type in at any point in time. Do this. Okay, Hia and Param got something. Ruchir Singh, Param modified the answer. Your graduation day will happen online.
So they haven't told anything, but it seems like that.
So you never get to go to school in class 12th. Your school got over in 11th itself. All right. So I don't type correctly. Why don't you type correctly? Okay, I'll do it now. Fine. So again here, the velocity is like this. Velocity is perpendicular to the rod and magnetic field both. So I can safely write down EMF is BLV, right? Velocity is perpendicular to length as well as magnetic field. All of you can see that?
Yes.
Current is equal to BLV by R. This is the current. Okay. So magnetic force is B square L square V by R. Which direction the force, magnetic force will be? If I draw an inclined plane looking from side, and let's say this is the wire that goes inside this red dot. So which direction the magnetic force will be?
Up the slope.
Up the slope?
Yes, sir.
This is B. This is the direction of the velocity. Okay, it'll be up the slope, correct. Magnetic force will be up the slope. This, okay. This is your magnetic force. What if the magnetic field would have been like this? Then which direction the magnetic force would have been? If magnetic field would have been like this, magnetic force would be in which direction?
So not same direction.
What?
Magnitude. So it would be in the same direction, up the slope.
No.
It would be leftward.
It will be perpendicular to the magnetic field as well as length. Perpendicular to magnetic field is this direction. That direction will be the magnetic field force. Magnitude wise, it will be same, but direction will be like this. Into the slope is the wire. Okay, wire is going into the screen. Okay, the magnetic force is like this. All of you understood this point? No doubt.
Yes.
Okay. All right. Now see, it is a straightforward situation. Magnetic force is upward, and if the steady state velocity, if velocity keeps on increasing, magnetic force keeps on increasing. When velocity becomes so big that the magnetic force matches the mg sine theta, the sine alpha, then the velocity will become constant. There is no other force along the incline, right? So mg sine alpha minus b square l square v by r should be equal to zero. So velocity, you can find out mgr sine alpha by b square l square, right? These are the standard questions. You must get it. So, what is the answer? You have to take projected length perpendicular to the velocity, which is this length, 2R. Okay. So EMF is BL into V. This one. Okay, Param got something. Kritika got KTG, Ruchir. Okay. Ruchir correct. Kritika correct. Only two people got it correct. Abhiram, why you came so early? All right.
Wait, sir, just give me 1 minute.
To lele 1 minute. 1 minute I'll take to solve also. Tell me which component of the magnetic field will be used here. Horizontal or vertical?
Vertical.
Why? Because the magnetic field should be perpendicular to the length. Right? So magnetic field that is vertical should be utilized here. What is given to us is horizontal component of magnetic field. Aeroplane is flying horizontally. So I have to take the vertical component of the magnetic field. So magnetic field vertical divided by magnetic field horizontal. This is equal to tan of 60, which is root 3. So vertical component of magnetic field is root 3 times the horizontal component, 2 into 10 is minus 5. Okay, and then you can get the value of EMF, which is BLV. So root 3 times 2 into 10 raised to power minus 5 BL, which is 20 into velocity 250, you'll get around 0.173 volts as the answer. Understood, Mehul, clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, I got the answer.
Good. See, I'm taking a lot of school level numericals also.
So is there a figure? It's shown in figure.
Copper rod, angle loss, omega. It's simple. It's shown in figure, hata.
Okay.
In a uniform magnetic field that is going into the board. Okay. It is rotating in the board. Derive it, okay? You may know the answer, derive it. Very good. So I can see, I hope you're not remembering and answering. You have a rod that rotates with angular velocity omega. So all the length is perpendicular to magnetic field. But the problem is velocity magnitude is different at different points. So I cannot use this formula BLV directly. So I have to take the help of calculus. I'll take a small strip here at a distance of r dr thickness. This entire dr will be moving with a velocity of omega r. So a small emf induced in dr is b into dr into velocity, which is omega r. So total emf will be integral of that. So it will be b omega L square by 2. I think it's direct. Okay. Now going forward, we are not going to take direct formula substitution questions. Do this. Okay, some of you answered. Ruchir Singh got it. I think Parekh also got it. Chaitanya, what is by root 8? What does it mean? Okay, should I solve? Fine. Omega is the constant acceleration with which the rod is moving upward starting from point O. Okay. So this distance y, I can write it like this. Y is equal to half omega into t square. Initial velocity is zero. Okay. So the length of the rod which you should consider for EMF is this one, right? This is the length of the rod which you should consider. Okay. And this distance is your X coordinate for the rod. This is also X only. So the length is 2 times of X. So this is point Y. So whatever is the X coordinate is this distance I'm saying. And due to symmetry, the total length is 2x. Okay. So EMF is B into length of the rod, which is 2x, into the velocity, that is dy by dt. Velocity, we could have written omega into t directly because v is equal to u plus at. This into omega into t. Okay. Now, I want to write as a function of y only. I don't want x. I don't want t. So x I can write as a function of y, like x is equal to root of y by a. And t, from here you can write t as root over 2y by omega. Okay, so you simplify this, get the answer. Understood, all of you? Type in. Okay. Abhay, answer. Okay. I think this is again direct formula based. See, what is given in the question, what is shown in the diagram are different. So A is this. This is A. If you read the question. Okay, so the EMF is BLV in which all three are constant. But over here, with the length, magnetic field is changing. Velocity and length, they are same, but magnetic field is changing. So I'll again consider a strip in the direction of the change so that I can say the strip is thin and the change is negligible inside that strip. So at a distance of r, a strip of dr is taken. The magnetic field is mu naught I divided by 2 pi r. So EMF is BLV. So mu naught I by 2 pi, L is dr, and this is 1 by r dr, this is velocity v. So EMF is integral of that. And when you integrate, the r will go from A to A plus L. So this will be mu naught IV by 2 pi natural log of A plus L divided by A. 1 plus L by A. This is our EMF. Okay. I think this should not be difficult.
So I don't think they're given the direction of the field.
Direction of field.
It won't matter actually.
Take like that. What else you want?
So that's all. So everything else given.
If something is not given in exam, you consider it to be the most obvious one, because if you attempt, then only you probably get the marks for wrong question. Okay, Ruchir Singh got something. Rahul Mishra. Others? Can I write it like this? A battery of some EMF with R equivalent. Where R equivalent is R plus R1, R2 divided by R1 plus R2. I can do that, right? EMF is BLV. So the current is BLV divided by this R equivalent. Okay? Clear to everyone? These two resistances are in parallel and this resistance is in series when they have become parallel because battery is here only. Clear to others who did not answer, type in. Is it clear?
So, but how can we just do R equivalent is equal to this?
Why?
So, because in each of the things, like both of the loops are trying to drive current in opposite directions along that line.
When you do the Lenz's law, it will be same direction.
One person speak. Ah, Param, what are you saying?
1 minute, sir. Let me just check.
Okay, I'll bring up the next question here. Meanwhile. Doubt?
No, sir, I made a mistake.
Do this. Richard Singh got something. Discuss now.
Yes, sir.
Rajdeep, you got the answer?
No, sir.
Okay. So we have a square frame of a side A, a long wire, located frame translates to the right with constant velocity, find the EMF induced as a function of X. So what is the EMF, what formula comes into mind when you see this thing? There's a loop is a magnetic field. They're asking induced EMF. So this formula should come in your head, right? Okay, so for somehow I should get d phi by dt over here. Let us see how we can do that. Here, I need to find the flux because the magnetic field is changing with the distance. Along the distance, I'll take a strip at a distance of r, I'll take a strip of width dr. Okay, so for that strip, the flux in it, magnetic field is going into the area is also parallel to it, as in entire the angle made by area and the magnetic field is zero. So B into A only for that a small this thing. It will be mu naught I divided by 2R to pi R into A at dr like this. Okay. Fine. So over here, I will integrate and get the flux first. D phi is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi, mu naught I A by 2 pi, dr by r, integrate it. R will go from x to x plus a. And this is from 0 to phi, total flux. So I'll get flux to be equal to mu naught I A by 2 pi natural log x plus a minus log x. And then you differentiate with time, you'll get EMF. Okay. The dx by dt is velocity v. So just differentiate, you'll get the answer. Any doubts? EMF as BLV. Yes, why not? We can take that. Yeah, that would be simpler, you know, doing all of this. If you take BLV, there are these two rods only, this rod and this rod. So these two rods can be considered as two batteries like this, like that. So this EMF minus that EMF is the answer. E1 minus E2, there is no EMF induced in this rod and that rod because velocity is parallel to the length. Okay, so yeah, you can get it as mu naught I by 2 pi x b l is a into v blv minus mu naught I by 2 pi x plus a into A into V. So this minus that, even that way you'll get the same answer only. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Rajdeep, clear?
Yes.
All right. So the inductor starts.
So here, which flux do we take?
Which flux do you take? Tell me.
I don't know, sir.
You take the cross-section area where the maximum amount of flux will be passing through when you calculate the self-inductance. That is why there is a hint given in the diagram itself. Take a rectangular plate like this, right? So through that, you take the flux. Find out the flux through the rectangular plate. Okay. This is equal to L times current. What is the magnetic field due to the outer current over here somewhere in between?
Zero.
Zero, right? So magnetic field will only be because of that. Okay. How the magnetic field will be? Circular. Okay.
So could you give me half a minute?
What?
So could you give half a minute more? Almost.
Rukja. You consider the ampere circuit. Okay. You consider ampere circuit and you can find out the magnetic field. Now do it. Okay, did you find the flux? Magnetic field is mu naught I by 2 pi r, as if it is a current carrying wire outside it. Okay, you can apply Ampere's circuit law. B into 2 pi r is equal to mu naught I. Same thing you get. This is the magnetic field. So this same magnetic field is throughout this strip, the orange one. So the flux through that, the small amount of flux through that is mu naught I by 2 pi r, B into area, that is length into dr. Total flux will be integral of that. When you integrate, you get mu naught L by 2 pi log of B by A. To integrate from B to A, that times current. So this bracket term is your self inductance L. Fine. Done, anyone? Hey, Ruchi Singh, got something? Others? Get the expression, okay? Get the expression in terms of L naught, capital L, mu naught. Don't need to tell the final answer. All right, we'll do it now. How many meters of the thin wire required to manufacture a length L naught and inductance L if solenoid cross section is considerably thick? So inductance L should be equal to mu naught N square. What is the formula? Into area, that is pi R square, to length L, okay? So the length of the wire, amount of wire should be how much? How we calculate that length?
Number of turns into 2 pi r.
So 2 pi r into small n into L. This is what the amount of wire it will be have. One loop will have 2 pi r length. That into number of turns is the total length. Okay. Now R, you can get it from there. So R is equal to square root of L divided by mu naught N square pi L. Fine. Just put the value here, get the answer. That's it. Ruchir Singh, Parek, others? KTG? Hiya, others? the current is decreasing, which one is at higher potential? This side of the inductor or that side, right or left? Right hand side is at higher potential, it will try to increase it. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So VA minus current 10 ampere into 2 plus 12 plus 5 millihenry L di by dt. This is equal to VB. See, if you want to use, it is decrease, right? So actually di by dt is minus 10 raised to power 2. So you could have written minus L di by dt in the formula, then substitute di by dt as minus 10 raised to power 2 because it is decreasing. Or if you don't want to be depending on the mathematics, you know that this is lower, this is higher. You should add the potential difference. So like this also you can do it. So you will get VB minus VA as equal to minus 8 plus 0.5, right? Minus 7.5 volts. Understood, Rajdeep, Chaitanya, here, KTG?
Yes, sir.
Who is that? Rajdeep tha kya?
Sir, it's me only. I say yes. So.
Okay, looks like you sang a song. Do you sing a song?
No.
Sometimes we miss the classroom. Do this. Anyone close to the answer? Get the expression you want. In school, what is going on?
So we are done with the syllabus.
We're doing division.
Oh, great. Fine, so let's do this. After this, we'll take a break. An inductor, a resistance, and you have a battery. RLE. So when you close the switch, we know it, like when you derive it, you'll get the growth of the current like this. Current is equal to V by R, 1 minus e to the power minus of RT by L. Time when current is 1 ampere approximately. So if you can substitute the value, 1 is equal to V is 12 by 6. Substituting values, because values are straightforward, they are integers, so probably it gets simplified. So we have e to the power minus RT by L to be equal to half. Take log both sides, you will get RT by L to be equal to natural log 2. So from here, T is equal to L by R, ln 2. What is ln 2? You remember?
0.693.
So L by R into that is the answer. Okay. So let's take a break. We will meet after that. Fine. So come back in time. Do this. Current 0 at t equal to 0. You have to find time dependence current. After time t, what it is. No one?
So 1 minute.
1 minute, yeah.
Sure. Just write down the Kirchhoff loop rules, you'll get the answer. Done. Differential equation. Fine. So let's see this is current I. Take this as I1, because di1 by dt terms will be there. This is I minus I1. So we have E minus I1 times R minus I times R is equal to zero. And in the second loop over here, you have minus of L di1 by dt plus I minus I1 times R is equal to zero. Now what to do? Anyone?
You should eliminate I minus I1.
No, eliminate I. Okay. So from the first equation, you'll get I to be equal to E plus I1 R divided by 2R. Just check that.
Yes.
Then substitute that I over here. You will modify entire equation into I1. Okay. So if you do it properly, you'll get a differential equation like this. D L D I1 by dt plus I1 by 2 times R is equal to E by 2. Anybody got this differential equation?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So when you solve this, you know, take this term over there and then separate the variables. You'll get I1 is equal to E by R 1 minus e to the power RT by 2L. Okay. Now there is a simpler way of doing it without differential equation. Can you solve this? Can you think of any other way of doing this question?
So could we look at the final and initial states and try predicting?
No.
So we can find the effective time constant and then substitute in that equation.
How will you get that? See, so I think wait. I want this circuit to look like this. If I make this circuit look like this, then I know the direct formula, isn't it? Can I make it look like this? L and some R equivalent and some E equivalent. Can I do that? Let me modify the circuit a bit. Can I say the circuit is this, then another EMF? Can I say it is like this? R, E, over here EMF is zero. Can I say that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So E by R plus 0 by R is equal to E equivalent by R equivalent, where 1 by R equivalent is equal to 1 by R plus 1 by R. So R equivalent is R by 2. So you'll get E equivalent to be equal to E by 2 and R equivalent to be R by 2. So now it is simple, right? R equivalent is R by 2, E equivalent is E by 2. So wherever in the equation R comes, put it as R by 2. You know that equation of single inductor and resistance is E by R 1 minus e to the power minus RT by L. So whenever E comes, put E by 2. Wherever R comes, put R by 2. You'll get this directly without differential equation solving. Okay. You consider this as internal resistance of this. This is done. I have taken more questions on inductor because I know what you will ignore. How you do this question, anyone? How you proceed?
Like, do we find out the energy that will be stored in the inductor, and then after that, that will get dissipated as heat?
Why that will get dissipated?
So because the switch is disconnected, and then it's just discharging of the circuit.
No, it will get discharged here as well as there only, right? Both places it will get discharged. They're asking you how much heat generated in the coil. Over here, how much? How will you know?
Okay.
So the coil will lose all its energy because current at infinity be zero.
Current is?
Current at t equal to infinity will be zero. And before it was I, so half Li squared will be heat.
So we can say that whatever the heat is dissipated in both of them, it'll be proportional to their radii. So the heat dissipated by the coil will be 1/3 of the total thing, because it's
radii.
Resistance, not radii. Sorry.
Resistance.
So 1/3 of the total heat will be the coils.
I mean, that is tricky to say because heat is I square. Okay.
So, but I will have to be the same. It's a closed circuit for both of them.
What?
I will have to be the same for both of them because it's a closed circuit, right?
Correct. I has to be same. Correct. You're correct. So it is proportional to R. Yeah, that way you can solve. That is one way. Other way, suppose you are not very confident about that scenario, which you know, I am also not so confident. But then yeah, we can always verify whether that is fine. And that should be fine actually, because current I is flowing through R and R naught, so it should be proportional to R only. Total energy is half Li square. That will only get dissipated because resistance can't store the energy. So 1/3 of that, you said, right? 1/3 should be the answer. Okay, this is one way. Suppose I want to solve it by using brute force first principle. How will you go about it?
So do you find the current and then do I square R and integrate?
So what is the current? Current is how much?
So we'll get current as a function of time with this.
How? It's E by R, e to the power. You remember all of this. If you get a differential equation, you solve it, you'll get this.
Yes. Okay.
So this is the current over here. It slowly decreases to zero. So the energy that is dissipated is I square R dt integral and zero to infinity. Okay. Clear to everyone?
Sir, I didn't get why only half Li squared won't work.
What? Say it again.
Sir, I didn't get why only if we do half Li squared, we won't get the thing.
See, half Li square will dissipated, it will get dissipated in both the resistance. Okay. So what Param said is that it will be proportional to the resistance, whatever heat get generated. So that's why 1/3 of the heat will be here, over here, and 2/3 will be liberated over there. So I'm convinced that yes, it should be like that. But you know, I still want to check whether I will get that only. So Param, can you check it after the class?
Okay, sir. Fine.
Okay, so Param, yeah, like that, and otherwise Param will not do it. Param will check. Okay. Yeah, both ways you get the energy, and let us know whether you get the same answer.
Okay, sir.
It'll be interesting. And I think it should be same. Otherwise, it will be against conservation of energy. This is done. Okay. Okay. Now let's look at the integer types. I have many questions actually. I have collected more than required. Okay, Ruchir Parekh got something not correct. Chaitanya got it correct. Okay, others. I think it's a simple, straightforward question. KTG got it.
Wait, sir, can you give me 1 minute at least?
I've already given 2 minutes. Take one more minute. Answer will be an integer. No, Ruchir Singh, that is not correct. Rahul Mishra got it. Mishra ji got the answer. Okay, Mehul ho gaya hai, 1 minute. Param also got it. Okay, so the effective length, how much you should take? This length is how much?
So 0.3.
0.3, that is 2 into 0.3 into sine of 30. Effective length is 0.3 meters only. Okay. So the EMF is BLV. B is 5. BLV is 4. Kitna ho gaya ye? BLV is 6 volt. This is 6 volt. The power is what? E square by R equivalent. That should be the power. That is 36 by R equivalent is 6 and 3. What is the R equivalent? 6 and 3?
So 2.
So, but even the resistor has resistance. Like that line.
Resistance has resistance.
Like the thing that's moving that has resistance.
Okay, this has 1 ohm. So 6 and 3, 2. 2n plus 1, 3. So 36 by 3, 12 watts. Now, once you're very close to the answer, take 1 second pause. 1 second pause and see what they're asking. 3x watt. This is 3x. So x is equal to 4. If you jump your gun like, yeah, I got 12. So let me write the 12. It'll be some mistake which you'll remember rest of your life that you did like this. In the exam. All right. Some weird question. Okay. 1, 3, 4, all kinds of answers. Others? Chaitanya is saying 3, Pradyut is saying 4. Oh, Pradyut is here. Okay, okay. Okay, here, why it is 4?
Sir, I think it is the same case as when a rod is moving about its axis with some angular velocity.
Why it is having rotation, right? It is moving forward also.
So,
the disc is rotating, right? Pure rolling is happening. So, rod is moving forward or not?
Yes, sir.
You did not consider that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Pradyut, why it is 4?
So, even I to consider translation.
Param, why it is 4?
Right, saw that I'm working on it now.
Abhay?
I did it and then I realized that I'm... Yeah.
But the correct answer is 4 only. Now tell me why it is 4. All of you. Okay, so you need to consider the rod EMF developed as a function of time will be this. Okay. At this moment, when rod is like this, the center of mass velocity is along the rod, okay? And the entire velocity that is perpendicular to rod is omega r only. Okay, so you have to consider the velocity that is perpendicular to rod. So the parallel to rod velocity doesn't affect. So that is only omega into r in this position. But I am wondering that suppose it becomes vertical, then the situation will be different. Velocity of this point will be VCM minus omega r, like that it will be.
So it'll switch polarities, right? After pi by 2.
So, correct. You know, when the rod is like this, and when rod is like that, there will be a different polarity because right now, the perpendicular velocity is like that, then the perpendicular velocity will be like this. So polarity should get reversed. So 4 should not be the answer. Why 4 is given the answer? Not sure. Anyways, we need to properly solve it actually. So you can consider the rod like that. This angle is, let's say, omega t. So over here, the VCM is like this. So its component perpendicular to the rod is how much? This is V omega t. So V sine omega t is perpendicular to rod. So perpendicular to rod, the total velocity will be omega r plus V sine omega t. Isn't it? All of you are able to understand what I'm trying to do here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So take a distance of r, thickness dr. So dE is BLV. So BL. This is V actually, L is dr. So integrate it. When you integrate that, it will become B omega r square by 2 plus B V r into sine of omega t. omega into r is v, so b vr by 2 plus b vr into sine of v by r into t. Okay, what happened? But it is rotating the other way. No, I'm considering that way only, the rotation. But yeah, I have considered this rotation starts when it is I have considered rotation the other way actually. That is why after time t it has gone like this. It should be, I should have considered down actually. I have considered it up at omega t. So what changes it will have? It'll be omega r minus of vcm into omega t. So that will come like this.
But also after integrating, you change it to cos.
Huh?
It'll become plus bvr into cos.
No.
After integrating with dr, right?
No. Yeah.
Yeah.
So the answer should not be 4.
It should be 3.
Should be 3. Yeah. Book is giving 4.
So wait, I don't understand why you took it from the bottom.
Because after time t, the rod will become like this, right? The wheel is rotating like this.
The rod. Oh, okay. So good.
Then you should take in minus b.
That is a minus, because VCM like this, its component perpendicular rod is opposite of omega r. Okay. Next. Integer types again. For this, you need to know magnetic field due to the loop along the axis. I'll write the expression because I am sure some of you do not remember that. Solve it completely.
Sir, is it into r square?
Yes.
Okay, sir.
Check it yourself.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Chaitanya got something. The smaller loop is very small, so you can consider entire magnetic field to be uniform throughout the smaller loop. So Ruchir Parekh got, Singh got, Chaitanya got, Mahit got. That's D is this. So the flux is mu naught I R square divided by 2 times. Z is how much here? Z is root 3. Okay. So root 3 meter, capital R is 1 meter. So root, so this becomes 3 plus 1, 4, 4, 2, it becomes 8, right? 8. This into pi R square. This is the flux. Okay. Current is equal to what?
We need to know the value of A.
What A?
I is equal to T A. Is that A?
T ampere.
A is ampere.
Oh, okay, fine. I thought that was some constant.
Okay, yeah. All right. So current is 1 by R d phi by dt. Okay. So when you do d phi by dt, only current is changing because of which flux is changing. So when you do d phi by dt, di by dt will come, that is equal to 1. So mu naught R square by 16 pi R square. This is your current. What we have to find out? Current only, right? So when you correlate, you will get, this is R. Capital R is 1 only, so gone. Okay. So when you correlate, you will get the value of X to be 1. X is equal to 1 is given to us. Okay, all of you clear?
So the capital R at the sir, bottom is resistance.
Yes, so that's resistance. Resistance.
Pi.
Yes, I am sorry. This is resistance. This is the radius. इसको क्या लिखें फिर ये कर दो
सो पाई ओम्स
पाई ओम्स पाई इज
यस सर 3.14
पाई लाइक दिस आर इज 1 हां नाउ या आई वाज वंडरिंग करेक्ट नाउ यू कैन कोरिलेट बेटर x इक्वल टू 1 ऑलराइट नेक्स्ट अप लेट्स लुक एट सम वियर्ड क्वेश्चंस नॉट दिस They have drawn circle instead of rod. The rod is going into your screen, so it will look like a circle, right? Final answer, I do not know. This question. its entire plane. The Z coordinate they have not mentioned. So the rod is sliding on this plane and the rod is this. This is your rod, which is sliding down. Will rod rotate also while coming down?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No.
It's smooth.
It requires torque to rotate. And anyway, radius is not given, right? Length L starts sliding from Y equal to A, uniform magnetic field EMF when it reaches the point of X equal to A by root 2. X equal to A by root 2. So Y is equal to how much? This is Y.
A by 2.
A by 2. So from A to A by 2, it has gained a velocity. Okay. Is velocity perpendicular to rod?
No, sir.
Velocity is not
the angle 45.
Velocity is not perpendicular to rod. Anything that happens in the plane is perpendicular to rod because rod is perpendicular to entire plane. Velocity is perpendicular to rod. But is it perpendicular to magnetic field?
No, sir, that's what I meant.
That's what you meant, huh?
So like I didn't listen properly.
That is the most important thing you have to do when you write exam. Read the question properly. Attention to detail. This is the magnetic field in the J direction. Is velocity perpendicular to magnetic field? No. You have to take perpendicular component of magnetic field. So if this velocity, is this velocity tangential to the curve? Yes, it is tangential. So if this is theta, you have to take cos theta component of the velocity, which is perpendicular to magnetic field. So tan of theta, there is a very nice way of finding out tan of theta, slope of the curve, dy by dx, that is 2x by a, right? So x is how much? A by root 2. So it becomes root 2 tan of theta. So cos of theta will become how much?
1 by root 3.
1 by root 3. So once you get velocity from u2 plus k2 equals to u1 plus k1, you will get the perpendicular component also. U2 is mg into a by 2. Y coordinate is a by 2 plus k2 half mv square, u1 is mga, k1 is 0. Okay, so m is getting cancelled out, that is why it was not given to us. V is equal to root of ga, right? V is equal to this, so perpendicular component is root of ga into cos of theta. So root of ga by 3. So EMF is BLV. So B naught L into this. N is equal to 3. Clear to everyone? Type it. Let's proceed. Let me go backwards. Oh. Don't worry. Figure may look different, but it's not difficult. Done? Anyone? Close to the answer?
Yes, sir. 1 minute.
So which resistances are with, sir?
Is it not clear? What is the doubt?
So for the horizontal plane, are both of them 1-1?
Yes.
Okay, sir.
So almost done, 2 minutes.
Okay, I'll do it now.
So could you read out what MA is equal to?
2 pi mu naught I naught by pi square. Pi numerator may be, denominator may be. Yeah. They could have cancelled it. Anyways, listen here, all of you. These 1 ohm, suppose there is a current, let's say I, over here. Okay. These 1 ohm will have same current or not?
Yes, sir.
This one will have different current. Okay. So current in 2 ohm will be half of the current on the 1 ohms. Isn't it? Let us find out first total current. In order to find total current, let's find out equivalent resistance. 1 by equivalent resistance is 1 by 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 by 2. So R equivalent is how much? 2 by 7 ohm. Okay. So current is how much? V by R, that is 7 ampere. Okay. Now I know that these three currents are equal. 1 ohm currents are equal, and this is half of it. So I can say 3 times of equal currents plus the I1 by 2 should be equal to 7. Okay. So I1 will become how much?
2.
I1 is 2, clearly. Okay. Now go back to the figure. Here the magnetic field because of this horizontal ring will be how much at the center?
Zero.
And magnetic field due to these two currents they will also try to cancel out each other. So you treat it like half of the circle. Magnetic field will be mu naught I1 divided by 4, radius is A, minus mu naught into I1 by 2, which is 1 divided by 4 of A. This is the magnetic field. Everybody understood this? Net magnetic field we have got. Clear, right?
Yes.
Mu naught by 4A. This is the magnetic field. And then you have a magnetic dipole moment M. So torque is what? MB sine theta. MB sine of theta is torque, which is equal to I alpha. Now here you have to see that it is diametric axis they are taking, for which moment of inertia is MR square by 2. Okay, small m and small r are given. But dipole moment is also small m. Mass is also small m.
So in the end, if you simplify it, you just need MA. And then you can put the thing in everything.
Let us take the dipole moment as mu. Mu. Dipole moment is actually current into area only. Is current on the loop is given?
Yes.
Yeah. So why to use all of this? We can directly write it as I naught into pi r square. This is equal to m r square by 2 into alpha, right? So alpha is equal to r square is gone. Alpha is equal to 2 into current into pi into b divided by m into theta. Okay, because angle is very small, I'm considering the oscillations here. So this thing is omega square. All right. Okay. So once you get the omega square, under root of that is omega, time period is 2 pi by omega. And everything else after this is mathematics only. That you are anyway good at.
So is it MR squared only for the link?
One person speak, Ruchir Parekh, what are you saying?
So is it moment of inertia only MR squared for the ring?
No, it is rotating about diametric axis.
Okay, yes sir.
So about the diameter, moment of inertia is MR squared by 2. Singh, what you're saying?
So was the answer given 4?
Answer, I don't know.
I think it's 4. It's MR squared by 2, then it's 4.
All right. Let me check something else. If you are able to solve this, you're done with the chapter. Param got some answer. No, that is not the answer. If you're getting 36, that's not correct. Are you considering entire magnetic energy getting dissipated as heat? Both of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
That's not correct. Do you think I'll give you that kind? Okay, I'll give you a hint.
Could you give one more minute?
So are both of the currents in the same direction?
As shown.
So because for the second, like the one with inductance L, they're pointing in both directions.
Ignore that.
So then Kirchhoff's rule doesn't work.
Kirchhoff won't work? Okay, all of you tried. Ruchir, Parekh, done? No, that's not the answer. Okay.
One more minute.
I'll give a hint, na? The hint is current won't become zero. You have assumed current will become zero. Why it will become zero if I start reasoning that out? Do you have answer to that? It is an ideal inductor. Okay, done?
Almost done, 1 minute.
Okay, I'll not keep everybody waiting for that. All of you, listen here. So now we have initial energy, I know. Initial energy is half L I naught square plus half 2L into I naught square. Okay, this is initial energy. Final energy I have to find out. How to get that? Let us assume current won't become zero. But if current remains, can there be current through the resistance till eternity? Is it possible? Can there be current over here after a long time? Current is not possible there because if current is passing through this, energy will be lost. Energy loss happens if current goes through resistance. So if there is remaining current, if current remains, it will be on this part of the loop only, okay, nowhere else, because it can remain there till eternity. There is no energy loss happening there. This L, this is 2L. Consider that the loop has been formed and current is moving like this. This is the way, let's say, current is going. Just an assumption. Current is I, which is now, once current I starts flowing like this, can it sustain or can that be, can that go away after some time? What do you think, all of you? If somehow current remains like this, will it sustain forever?
Yes, sir.
Right? Current is not changing. So inductor is nothing. It's like a resistance-less path. So till current becomes uniform, till that becomes uniform, I have L d I by dt. Okay. Let's say current over here is I1 and over there it is I2. Di1 by d2, L di1 by d2 should be equal to 2L di2 by dt. Did you get this equation? They are connected parallel, right? So dt dt, if you cancel, you have L into di1 is equal to 2L into di2. I can cancel out L also. So change, when you integrate, it will become change in current in the first one should be equal to 2 times change in current in the second one. This, as long as this is satisfied, Kirchhoff's law is valid and everything is as per the laws. So change, if the final current is I, what is the change in current in this? Delta I1 will be how much, everyone?
I minus I1.
I naught plus I.
I naught plus I. I naught plus I. Okay, they are reversing the direction. Okay, this should be equal to 2 times. Now, which direction you're taking positive? Downward, you have taken positive, right? No, upward is positive. Final minus initial. Upward is positive. Now, delta I2 is how much? Over here, change in current is what? Final current is downwards, which is negative. Minus I, minus of minus I2. Are you getting this? Not I2, I0. Are you guys able to understand what I've done here? 2 times I0 minus I. Okay. So I will be equal to I0 by 3. So this much current will be sustained. All of you type in, is it something which you have understood?
So from the loop, shouldn't you take like let's say shouldn't you base your sign on the loop direction? Like, shouldn't I have taken that current to be positive?
You can take any sign. You can take that any sign. You're taking sign on the left hand side as well as right hand side. If your convention is proper, both sides can become negative, both sides will become positive. So sign convention doesn't matter.
No, sir. Shouldn't it be like, shouldn't upwards be positive on one side and downwards be positive on the other side? Because I want to keep positive around the loop.
No, not like that. You just look at the resistance only and look at the change in current there. So if final current is I, the final energy is half Li square plus half 2L into I square. Okay. Everybody understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Param, fine.
So like, I didn't really get it. I don't know how, like, why it's negative on that side. Because whenever we leave loops, don't we take the positive direction, which is along the loop over there?
Okay, you mean to say that why I'm taking this one like this, and I get it. You're trying to say clockwise take one direction, anti-clockwise take another direction. Like that you're telling me?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
But then I'm not looking at the loop. I just care about what is happening to this inductor. Okay, what's happening to this inductor? And right now current is I naught over here like this. Later on the current is how much? Current is I. So change in current is I minus I naught there. Okay, let's say that is a change in current. Yes. Now this is the change in current, and for the other one, if I write like this, the way you're telling me, for the other one, if let's say the final current is this way, I, and initial current is this, I naught, then this will be equal to what? Final current is upwards, right? So final, I have taken over here, I have taken downward to be positive.
So what I'm saying is, shouldn't you take downward positive on this side and take upward positive on that side? Because whenever we do things in a loop, that's what we do, right?
No, not
here. It's delta I1 equal to delta.
No, you don't do that here, because here their EMFs are equal. When you consider loop rule over here, you subtract it, EMFs. This EMF minus that EMF, you do it. Okay, even though current will be like this only, but two EMFs you subtract or add. So their deltas will get subtracted. If you really want to do that way, you need to subtract their deltas and equate that to zero.
Okay, so.
Okay, just do it again your own way properly, and then we can discuss it further in a more specific manner. Whatever you're saying. What?
So would we get it if we find the power across the resistor and integrate that across time?
Dissipated in the resistor. Yeah, of course you can do that. If you can.
No. Okay. Yes.
Have you done like that?
So I tried like that. I didn't get anything.
I did what Richard said, and I got that to me. I got 8 joules.
Okay, so can you share it after the class?
Yes, sir.
Just see that. Yes. Okay, here you just, I think you have taken the loop rule only, right? Along this loop and then that loop and then.
Yes. Probably,
yeah, this current plus that current is equal to this current. You probably have done that way. You should get the same answer actually. But when you do I square R, current will go to zero when t tends to infinity. So it should take care automatically. But initially current, what you have taken? Initial current, 2I naught. Yeah, you should get the answer. Should get it. You want me to check the answer for this?
Yes, sir. So otherwise we'll try it and send after class only again.
Okay. Meanwhile, you do the next question. I'll check the answer for this and let you know, because Ruchir probably have solved that way. This is do this. Answer is 32, Ruchir. 32.
Yes, sir.
अच्छा वेट वेट लेट मी गो देयर लेट मी आंसर द परम परम हियर सी व्हेन यू आर राइटिंग इट लाइक दिस यू आर कंसीडरिंग बोथ करंट डाउन राइट
यस सर
सो व्हेन यू कंसीडर बोथ द करंट डाउन इन दैट केस ओनली यू हैव रिटन लाइक दिस फॉर दैट केस यस नो
यस
Now you got it?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
So downward is positive for both. Otherwise, you write one is equal to minus of the other. But that was a good question. Param's question. Get the answer here.
Wait, sir, can you go back again?
Abhi ruk ja, pehle tu ye solve kar. Get the answer. We'll go back, don't worry. Okay, what is the answer? Anush got something?
Sir, just give me one more minute.
One more minute I'm giving. Others? Anush, check the silly errors. No, no one got correct answer till now.
So,
So
I sent the answer on WhatsApp the way Ruchir said it.
No, you just tell the integer, right? Integer. Just tell me the answer, okay?
Sir, 30. No, not this one, sir.
Message.
The previous.
Are, so first tell me the answer for this one. What is K? Message it. See, we can, we cannot hold 25 students for just one question, which we are discussing individually, right? You have to move ahead. We'll discuss that appropriate time. Okay, so Ruchir also answered. Mahit got it correct. Only Mahit got it. Why others are not getting it? Is it difficult? This one has 10 ohms. This one has 15 ohms. This EMF BLV, that is 4. Mehul got something? Mehul? Is this correct, everyone? What I have drawn? What I have drawn is correct circuit or not?
That's it. Polarity will be opposite.
Polarity.
4 millivolt.
Polarity is ulta for this. Getting it? So, I think Ruchi, you did that mistake, right? E equivalent by R equivalent is equal to 4 by 10 minus 2 by 15. And we have to take minus because polarities are reversed. 1 by R equivalent is 1 by 15 plus 1 by 10. How much you get E equivalent here? E equivalent comes out to be how much? Mahit? Can't hear you. This is what you get, E equivalent, okay? The current will be equal to E equivalent, which is 24 by 15 divided by the resistance. Total resistance is how much? Current in the 5 ohm resistance. So 10 and 15 from here, R equivalent will be how much? R equivalent is how much? 10 and 15.
10.
How can it be 10?
Six ohms, sir.
6 ohm, pakka?
Yes, sir.
5. Sota kya rehta hai, Rahul?
Sir, I'm not sleeping, sir.
You sound as if you're sleeping. What is that? Be more attentive in the class. What is K then? K is 8. Okay. Okay. So I'll just go there briefly. Previous question. Huh. What are you saying, Param?
So don't we get this equation by using the loop only? Because
No. By using loop, you get minus of L di1 by dt minus of 2L di2 by dt is equal to 0. So using loop equation, you get 1 is equal to minus of the other. Are you getting it? So then your whatever you're saying now, that will work. But you get the same equation. Got it? I have taken plus. Okay.
How did this equation come in?
Arre ruk ja, param samajh mein aaya?
So like if we take the loop, right, then we get L di1 by dt minus.
Why minus?
2L in, so because no. We're going opposite to the current.
No. Current is fine. Ultimately, current will start flowing in the same direction. You're considering the same direction, right, for the current like this, clockwise, anti-clockwise. So L di1 by dt plus 2L di2 by dt is equal to 0. That is what you will get. I have considered to be in the same direction, down. So that is why for me, it is 1 minus other is equal to 0.
Okay, so yeah, fine. That makes sense. Yes.
Ruchir Parekh, you're saying something?
So how can we consider them in the same direction, sir?
I have considered. I have considered because I wanted to equate their potentials only. This potential equal to that potential. That's all.
Oh, okay. Yes, sir.
But then, yes, I can understand the difficulty Param had. So you can consider in the clockwise only and do the way you just go by the rules. You'll get the same answer. Okay. Don't worry about it. Okay. Let me find something. Okay. Multi-correct, okay? More than one option.
So is this multiple correct?
हाँ बोला ना मैंने multiple correct.
Okay.
Okay. No one is getting. Others? Okay. You guys need more time?
So 1 minute, sir.
2 minutes le lo, but get the answer. Okay, only Ruchir, Parekh, Chaitanya and Ruchir Singh. Nobody else. Hiya, what is your answer? Param, what is your answer?
I'm getting some weird things for all of them.
Advik? Pradut? Tiga. So let us say the velocity of the rod is V. Okay? So if velocity of the rod is V, doesn't matter what force and what not, the EMF should be BLV. And if EMF is BLV, charge stored on the capacitor is C times EMF, which is C BLV. Okay, understood? This is the charge. Now, if this is the charge, current is dQ by dt. So C BL into acceleration A. So option one is correct. Okay. And if this is the current, there will be a magnetic force of IL into B. Okay. So C B square L square into A is a magnetic force. This minus magnetic force is mass times acceleration. So acceleration is F divided by M plus C B square L square. So even three is correct. Everyone understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let me see. Yeah, guys, consider. Let us see. Last question for today. If it takes more than 3-4 minutes, will it? I think it will take. So this is the last question. Do it, all of you. Anyone? Chaitanya got something? No, Chaitanya, that's not correct.
Yes, I made a mistake. I'll just...
Take your time. We have a lot of time. Okay, no need to rush. No one is close to the answer. Anyone?
So I got a differential equation that I don't know how to solve.
You got a differential equation. Do you need a differential equation?
Yes, sir.
So I think I sent the answer.
You don't need a differential equation. Kaha answer tune send kiya hai? Chaitanya. Haan, Chaitanya, that's correct. Okay, so this is equivalent to two circuits. This battery supplying double power to power the capacitor as well as the inductor. Both the potential difference are V naught only, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Kya hua Rajdeep, super excited. You're excited because class is getting over or what?
Yeah, this is normal only, yes.
We are having one more hour extra today. Is that fine?
No, actually.
Okay. So this is equal to V naught by 8 into 1 minus e to the power minus of RT by L. Okay. And I2 is equal to V naught by 8 again, 1 minus e to the power minus T by RC. All of you understand this? Everyone?
So, but how, why can we split it that easily? Why, like, why can't one component influence the other?
It is Kirchhoff loop rule only. V naught minus 4 di1 by dt minus 8 times i1 is equal to 0. This will lead to you this. And V naught minus q by c minus i2 into 8 will lead you to this. Isn't it? The loop equation over here is similar to loop equation there. Loop equation here is same as that. Getting it?
Yes, sir, but I thought that we would have to like eliminate V naught and then solve the combined thing because one can influence the other one.
What do you mean by one influences the other?
Like if the capacitance is like, because the capacitor will start to remove the.
Now I understand what you're trying to say. See, the battery is electromotive force. This is acting like a force. It will not let the potential difference across these two points to go deviate from V naught. It will push it to V naught every time it tries to influence.
So that's okay. But like I2 will decay, right? And because of that, I1 will increase and the inductor doesn't.
I1 won't increase because of I2 getting decayed. The pressure on battery will be lesser then. Battery will have to do lesser work.
Okay.
Battery will, what is the function of battery? To maintain constant potential difference. That's all. Whatever happens.
But okay. How can we know that there's no influence and like that there can't be any influence?
Battery is there. Na? Battery will push. Battery will maintain a constant potential difference across these two points. It is like this. What you're asking is there's a pump. Okay. There's a water pump, which is pumping the water at a constant rate. Okay. You're telling me that some water will push the pump itself. So this rate should get influenced. My answer is whatever it is, the pump will adjust its power in such a manner that the flow rate coming out of the pump is constant. Okay. Similar kind of analogy here. The battery will adjust itself to maintain the potential difference constant. And it is all driven by potential difference, nothing else.
Okay, sir.
So I1 by I2 should be what? Value of I1 by I2 at t equal to ln2. So just put t equal to ln2 r by l, whatever you is values that are, what are values are given, you put it, you'll get it as 3. 3 is the answer. Okay. All right, so that's it. With respect to EMI, what?
So could you just see the answer I put on the group?
Which answer?
So that 32.
Are you sent me after the class? Oh, you sent on the group, is it?
Yes, sir.
This one, can I reply afterwards? It's a big two pager. And
yes.
Right? I'll reply on the group itself. All right, so it looks like some of you might have taken EMI for granted. So my purpose was to shake you up a little bit. I hope I have successful in that. And you know what all you don't know now. So make sure you strengthen your topics which are already strong. Make it so strong that whatever question comes, you should be able to answer it. Fine, so that's it. We'll meet next week and probably start class 11th now. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Hey, Rajdeep, 1 hour extra. Hold.
Thank you, sir.
Bye, sir. Good night.
Good night.